So welcome guys, welcome to my channel. Today's session we're going to try and hide out of the rain underneath this bridge. Got a nice bit of stretch of river underneath here, which is notorious for good fish. So I'm going to spend a bit of time here, fish it with some different methods, jigs and flies, and just see what comes out. Not sure what to expect, but probably give it a go. The weather is absolutely piddling it down. So we're going to give it a go underneath here in the dry for a while, and then I might explore out in the wetness later further up the river. Stay tuned.
One with a 7 gram cheb. See how it goes. Yeah, let's go a bit faster now. Rod up. Try and keep that fly a bit higher in the water. Then we'll do the tapping. Non-stop tapping now. fish in. Fish on. Oh yes, that's a good pike. Yet though, if he wants to run, he's going to run again. Oh yeah, lovely fish. Oh. Green and line off. Tighten up a tiny top. Oh, this is a good fish. These river fish bite like nothing else. I knew there'd be a monster under this bridge. In the net. Wow, what an absolute tank of a fish. Beautiful. Let's get her released.
Here's the fish, guys. Just shy of 18 pounds. Absolute tank of a pike. It's so thick. It was a beautiful fight on the light gear and gave me a run for my money. Caught him on the four metal racket fly from McFluffjucker. Brilliant stuff. Let's get it released now. give the big one a go.
Get it wet first. Another good fish. Oh.
Oh, it spat it. No. That was a monstrous fish. Oh dear, I can't believe it. I've got to try again.
That latched on pretty hard. It was on the drop. Again, this is a good fish.
My net's caught on some bloody metal. There we go. Oh shit.
This is another absolute tank of a pike. Didn't think it was ready. Guide it on round. Come on. full of beans. Yes, it's in the net. Oh my days. What an absolute beast. This one's bigger than the other one, I think. So guys, I've been fishing underneath this motorway bridge. It's been epic. The first fish I hit out was just shy of 18 pounds, and so I was super happy about that using a smaller fly. I decided to use my new big fly then, and this is the leftovers of it. Not sure if I can recover this one, but I'll give it a go. But I'll show you the fish. Absolute monster. I'm not sure if you can see, guys, but this thing's massive. 23 pounds of pure river mussel. Let's get it back. Oh, here we go again. Oh. Oh, you bugger. Landed this one, 12 pounds, again on the Muck Fluff Chucker Fly, on the fluoro one this time. Quickly get it released as it's nice and lively. But another beautiful fish from under the bridge. It's done me well under here today.
get it in. Okay guys, so I've had three good fish today. I've lost three as well. They didn't feel too big, to be honest, the other ones, but I'll keep telling myself that. So my first fish I had on one of these, this is a 4 metre racket. The fish was 17.8 pounds. The second fish I had was on, well, this was a big 13-inch perch fly. It does need fixing up again. Got demolished by a 23.5 pound pike. I've just landed another pike on the giant fluoro fly. This one is recoverable, thankfully, so I do like this fly. And that was only 12 pounds, but it's good fishing. Next, I'm going to give it a go with one of my old favourite patterns. This yellow and green 13-inch perch fly again. I'm going to stick a 7 gram cheb on there and see how we get on.
So guys, I'm going to call this the end of my session. I've been fishing for about 2.5-3 hours. Landed three good fish, lost three fish, and in the end I ended up snagging one of my favourite flies up. And as I'm told, I just thought, that's it, I'm calling it a day. So, bear with me, I'm going to get home now and rest up a cup of tea and edit this video that you've just watched. Thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe.